Here as we join Glenn McCrory and first Adam Smith.
The moment of truth and time to deliver for the unquestionably talented Ukrainian now based here over in Hamburg, Sergei Zinziruk, a precocious amateur who struck bronze and silvers in all the major finals and whose controlled technique, speed and guile has seen him almost effortlessly rise to 29-0 in the pro ranks. Now the long-awaited world title chance against another highly skilled operator in Daniel Santos. And I suppose, Glenn, it's whether he can grasp this opportunity tonight.
Well, it's been expected for a long time. He's a good prospect. He's coming through, got a great opportunity now, and so far in his career Zinziruk has done nothing wrong. 29 wins in 29 fights, 22 KOs, and that after an excellent amateur career. He's tall, a southpaw, and a very sharp boxer.
We've seen him back home in Britain. His first few fights were there, and he really did look an excellent boxer. But here comes one of the more accomplished, polished, and long-standing champions in boxing today, Daniel El Pilin Santos. He may not be an instantly recognizable household name, but he is well-regarded back in his Caribbean home of Puerto Rico, and he's well-traveled around Europe, taking care of both Neil Sinclair and Takalu in Britain. And he won the WBO welterweight title here in Germany. Back now to defend his 11-stone belt. And Glenn, he's proving hard to shift.
He certainly is, but he's been inactive for 15 months. This fighter who is definitely talented, at times frustrating, but has been an excellent champion at two weights.
There's only a handful of fights in the last few years for Daniel Santos, but his ability is right up there. Very slick, crafty, cool customer. Can be a touch lazy, but when he's on song, hard to get out of a rhythm. Here he comes again. Confident and composed, as always,
Der
Santos.
Der Weltmeister aus Puerto Rico, Daniel Santos.
And there is Zinziruk. RMC Gerhard Müller
in
German, and that's the record, 29-0, unbeaten so far in 6.5 professional years for Zinziruk. Santos, 29 wins in 33, only beaten twice in a career that goes back to September 96.
Sein 12. WM-Kampf aus Puerto Rico, der Weltmeister Daniel
WBO light middleweight champion. Our referee, Gino Rodriguez. Many world title fights he's looked after. And the judges tonight, Michael Pernick, our own Dave Paris here, and Joachim Jakobsen of Germany too.
Okay, I give you guys your instructions in the red dressing room. I want you to obey my commands at all times. I want you to protect yourself at all times. I want you to have a clean fight, all right? Now, touch gloves and good luck.
So Daniel Santos makes the sixth defense of the WBO light middleweight title he won 3.5 years ago, stopping Yuri Boy Kampas. He's back after a 15-month break due to promotional problems in an all-southpaw clash with his man as well-schooled and maybe even as good as Santos. First crack at the world crown for Sergei Zinziruk, and he starts a slight outsider, having not fought at this level, we hope, for an engaging meeting of minds and skills, Glenn.
Yes, we hope. Santos, you'll be looking for him to start pretty quick. He's the champion. He's away from home. He needs to get into this fight, get past the long arms of Zinziruk.
Zinziruk, the former European champion who gave up that title to concentrate on Daniel Santos. Both of them were excellent amateurs. They both fought in the Olympics in Atlanta, where Santos got a bronze and Zinziruk was knocked out in the second series. They didn't meet there, they do now.
Well, that was a good left hand from Santos. And already you're seeing their styles, both very similar, leading behind that southpaw right hand, both quite upright. And you can tell how they were very good amateurs, still with that slightly amateur style.
Get the high guard. Zinziruk trying to hold the middle of the ring and get that jab out. And that's good work from the Ukrainian.
So it was a good sharp right hand from Zinziruk. Both excellent jabs. Just trying to find the range and open up the defense with that jab.
Doubling up, Zinziruk. Maybe about who has the added zip, the added speed of hand. It's positive from Zinziruk.
Yes, he's getting the center of the ring, trying to push Santos on the back foot. And Manji now, two excellent jabs.
Good defense too. Looking sharp in this first round, Zinziruk, who's been much busier than Daniel Santos.
He's enjoying that extra height and reach, and he's making good use of it. Very, very sharp. He looks slightly the faster of the two here.
Santos back with a combination, but mostly hit gloves. And the accuracy, precision, and start has been made by Sergei Zinziruk. Very classy finish to the first round. We're in the Borderland Halle here in Magdeburg, Germany, and it was a very effective start from Zinziruk.
Well, Santos really needed to get the better of the starts, but it was Zinziruk who managed it. He started well behind that jab, used that very good effect.
Second round here, the black and yellow of the 29-year-old, originally from Ukraine, now based here in Germany, and picking up a following two. Sergei Zinziruk up against Daniel Santos, who's held this belt for almost 4 years. And most recently for him, put away Antonio Margarito, albeit by a clash of heads, but he was up on the cards. And that was a good win on paper.
Zinziruk electing to get the center of the ring, keeping Santos on the back foot. Santos trying to use that southpaw jab, but just falling short with his punches.
Sometimes two southpaws don't make for a great match, but already these two, where they've shaped up, it's going to be based on boxing technique and skills and a real battle and how they outthink each other, and that's good work from Santos.
Well, you have two fighters in here with very good technical ability, so it's blending well, the southpaw styles. Santos needs to throw his punches in combinations. That's where he seems to be getting Zinziruk.
He has got the experience, Daniel Santos. Former world welterweight champion too. Zinziruk up at world level for the first time in his life. But they've been waiting for this, haven't they?
Yes, it's been a good build-up for Zinsserov. He's taken the right opportunity. And remember, he's got Santos after a 15-month layoff. So it's a very good time for Zinsserov to make a challenge.
Look how well he gets his gloves up and defends the shots coming from Santos.
Well, that's the problem Santos has. He's throwing good volleys of shots, three, four punch combinations, but they're hitting the gloves of Zinsserov. That was better, that short little left hand. Showing his speed there, Santos.
Yeah, just a mark on the right cheek of Zinsserov from the left hand. Better for Daniel Santos.
That was another good left hand. That just seemed to shake Zinsserov a little bit. Didn't like that one.
The jab from Zinsserov and the combinations tried by Daniel Santos. Very interestingly poised, this world title fight. Close round.
Santos has used the combinations, just done a little more for me.
There's Michael Tim with Sergei Zinsserov, training in Hamburg. Might not have done quite enough that round.
No, Zinsserov started the round well, using the jab. But then it was Santos who got back in the second part of the fight, and he was throwing more combinations. And I think that worked better for him. Doubling up the southpaw right and then bringing that left hand in.
Fourth outing for Daniel Santos. 7-4 on favourite to retain his title. It looks like he's got a fight on his hands with his very accomplished Sergei Zinsserov in his 30th pro bout. And he's done very little wrong to date. And he's settling okay here. It's a big jump up from European level to Daniel Santos.
It certainly is. He hasn't really campaigned at world level yet, Zinsserov. So this is quite an ask, but he's got the advantage of being in Germany. And Santos has had that 15 months out.
Just to use his height and reach continually, Zinsserov. Santos with little bursts, but the lethargic tendencies that he's had in the past come back to haunt Daniel Santos tonight.
Well, I think in this fight he's going to have to work all the way through this, because that's the only way he's going to win it. He's got to try and do more than Zinsserov. He's got to be busy.
There's that lightning quick jab from Zinsserov.
Santos showing his experience, trying to throw his punches and combinations, getting off with good ones, showing his class now.
Is that the way to get through this oh-so-tight guard of Zinsserov?
It is the way to do it, but it's going to be hard because Zinsserov has that good jab. He's got to use that more. He's got to keep Santos off balance. Don't let him get set up to let those combinations go.
Claims an amateur record of 195 wins in 220 contests. Zinsserov, who's looking more mature as a professional now. Solid shots here in the third round.
Zinsserov coming on towards the end of the round. He's trying to catch the eye of the judges here. Just take the good early play away from Santos.
Stabs at his left eye, Daniel Santos. He's been frustrating in his career, despite getting good wins over the likes of Margarito and Takalu and Yuri Boy Campas.
Santos not looking that rusty. It's a decent round for him.
Well, an extremely tight first quarter of this 12-round world title affair. It's a pick'em so far.
Well, the round's very, very close. Both men getting through some good shots, and Zirik, an exceptional right hand there. But he was busier for me, Santos. Zirik relying on the jab for the most part. Santos trying to get the combinations on.
Plenty of anticipation in the build-up to this one, and as always in boxing, some sort of controversy. This time it was over the gloves. Daniel Santos wanted to use the Reyes puncher gloves, and Zinzirup, his own German brand, and the promoters won. So Zinzirup has the gloves he wanted. It's not going to come down to that, though, is it? It's going to come down to who is the better artiste, I think, here.
Well, it might even be down to who wants it more, because one or the other has got to... Just trying to do a little bit more. Zinzirik has a good high guard, catching a few of these on the gloves.
And the jab just popping back the head of Santos. He's working fairly hard, the Puerto Rican, but look at the way Zinzirik comes back with those eye-catching shots. Judges will note that.
Yes, Zinzirik threw a very good jab to the body. I like to see him do more of that. Just matching each other for jabs.
Excellent reputation when he fought in Britain, Zinzirik. He was a well thought of, and our current British champion Jamie Moore is a big fan. He'll be watching this closely. Now Zinzirik has given up the European title. That might be something for Jamie to aim for. But he's held in high esteem, Zinzirik, and at the moment is coping with life on the big stage.
Some nice work at long range there from Santos. Just peppering Zinzirik with that southpaw right, and then a very good right hook from Santos, who, you know, has got a, you wouldn't think he's been out for 15 years. He's very sharp here, 15 months, sorry.
Both have settled very quickly, and it is developing into an intriguing title clash between two very useful operators.
It's much more eye-catching, the jab of Zinzirik.
It's tight, it's close, and it's very, very clever boxing. Good end to the round again from Sergei Zinzirup. Crowd here enjoying this one. Tim joined by Volker Grill, Christoph Busch, and Magomed Shabanov.
Well, there's the solid jab from Zinzirik, throwing three there, each one hitting the target. But he's relying pretty much on that jab, not really having much more of a repertoire, where Santos throws an awful lot more punches.
The black and blue and the tattoos of Daniel Santos. Stands just under 6 feet tall from Bayamon in Puerto Rico. Defending his WBO 11-stone crown, the black and yellow of the six-footer, Sergei Zinzirik, who's been boxing behind the jab, the tight defense, and Santos trying to prise that apart.
Who are you leaning towards?
I'm leaning towards Santos, who I just think's that bit busier. It's an awfully good jab from Zinzurek, but it's the combinations that, for me, are more eye-catching from Santos. Certainly youngsters watching this contest should note the excellent jabs of these two.
And the excellent defense shown by the pair of them.
Well, showing why both of them have done so well in the amateur game and in the professional game.
Good work from Daniel Santos, who was a good amateur. Caught in the World Championship to only 17. Back comes Zinzurek. The action just warming up. Good little patch. Body shot from Santos too.
Well, we haven't seen either one use that many jabs. Zinzurek, the straight jab. Sorry, the straight body punch.
High-class skills. Neither wants to make a mistake, but both men are quite willing to commit themselves.
There's Zinzurek more on the front foot. Santos getting through the combinations. Much the same in every round. Each round's pretty close.
The volume, maybe with Santos, possibly the extra accuracy with Zinzurek. So, really what catches the eye. Santos there trying to drive his shots home.
Zinzurek's done better this round. He's been on the front foot, more forceful with the jab, looking to bring the left hand in as well. He's rocked that head back of Santos a few times.
And again with the jabs in Zurich. Marking his authority on this, his big night and big chance. Alejandro De La Torre, as always, looking after the corner of Daniel Santos. His father also in there, Luis Francisco. The whole family are here in Germany to support him.
Didn't look too happy with his work in the corner there, Santos. And I think, you know, he's realized he's been caught by too many jabs.
But it is nip and tuck, a tantalizing battle of wits between Daniel Santos and Sergei Zinzurek. Zinzurek, who's come up fairly slowly, been brought along at a quite gentle pace up to this opportunity. Former European light middleweight champion, first world title fight. For Santos, it's the sixth defense of his 11 stone crown, and he was previously the holder at 10 stone 7. Impressed, though, the way that Zinzurek has handled the move up.
Yes, he's doing very well. He's trying to take the play away from Santos. Keep the center of the ring, use that jab. So far, he's doing pretty well. Excellent left hand there. That looked to hurt Santos.
And again, jabs, straight shots. All going in from Zinzurek, much to the delight of his following here. Excellent burst from Zinzurek and a measured, controlled jab. And look about him too.
Well, this is the best work of the fight so far for Zinzurek. Really took control in this round.
I was with Philip Fondue a while back in Britain, and Fondue always raved about how classy Zinzurek was. And Daniel Santos is realizing that tonight. Remember, Santos only beaten twice in his life.
Well, he's been well outboxed in this round. Time and time again, that good southpaw jab rocks the head back of Santos.
And Let's just up the tempo here. Zinziruk. Can Santos live with the younger man?
Santos trying to get set, trying to throw some shots, and Zinziruk just puts that high hand guard right by the side of his face, catches the shots on the gloves.
Began boxing at just 9 years of age, won a silver in the Worlds and in the Europeans, Sergei Zinziruk. This is one very, very classy fighter. But we didn't know how he would react at this level.
No, well, it's been a good build-up, and he's certainly prepared when he gets there, and that's a good round for Zinziruk.
There's the family of Daniel Santos looking quite concerned and worried. His wife there and mother and father in the corner with Santos, who's shaking his head. What's the problem here? Is it with the speed of Zinziruk, the compact style?
Well, he's not happy. He's been caught with some very good jabs. And then in this round, Zinziruk started to bring the left hand into play. And he was caught an awful lot, Santos. And one of the things we're not seeing from Santos is good defense. He's very upright. He's not slipping from side to side. Zinziruk equally upright, but he's got those hands nice and tight to the chin.
Second half, world light middleweight title on the line. Remember the black and blue of Daniel Santos, the champion, against Sergei Zinziruk, and on your unofficial card, Glenn, it's everything to play for.
Yes, nicely poised. Decent work in the second and third from Santos, but now Zinziruk has pulled it back. And at this point, he looks in control. It's now down to the champion, Daniel Santos, to try and turn the play around. He needs to just move his head a little bit, start missing some of these jabs.
Santos has gone 12 rounds on a number of occasions. We remember against Takalu in the Cardiff Castle, when he outboxed the Margate-based Iranian. So Zinziruk has gone 12 in his last outing against Jimmy Colas in April. Looks in some control in there, Zinziruk now.
Yes, he looks as if he's really growing in confidence, and he's starting to hurt Santos with some of these punches. The crowd enjoying this.
Yeah, it's been fought at a fast pace. An excellent exhibition of skills. Santos just waiting, trying to prize through the guard. Those long arms, keeps those elbows tucked in. Difficult to get past him.
Santos trying to build up some momentum with his combination punches. He's finding it difficult to get through that high-held guard.
They've got 42 knockouts between them. So there is some power, certainly stinging, sharp punches in the ring. Another a massive banger.
Santos, who often takes little rests and goes to sleep in fights, he's not going to be able to do that in this one.
Yeah, he did do that in his last outing against Antonio Margarito, and against Ahmed Kotiev in Lubeck, and he lost a challenge for the World 10 Stone 7 title, really threw that away.
Having the occasional success, Santos, but the better work has been from Zinziruk.
Yeah, he's relaxed, he's composed, seems to be enjoying himself. Klaus-Peter Kohl, his promoter at ringside, applauding. And they'll probably be fairly happy, the Germans here, who have taken to Sergei Zinzurek. It's a good time for German boxing. Vladimir Sidorenko, Zsolt Erdai in his stable, both becoming world champions recently. Can he become the third in just 12 months?
Well, he looks to have the right game plan. He's taken the play away from Daniel Santos. He's leading well with the jab, and Santos struggling to get into this fight. Just falling short, and there's the quick counter. Doubles it up, trebles it up with that right hand, and then the left. That was his best round so far, Zinzurek.
Fairly open 11 stone division at the moment. WBO title on the line here. WBC held by the wild Nicaraguan Ricardo Mayorga. Alejandro Garcia has the WBA, and he's meant to be fighting the IBF champion, Romain Carmazine, in the new year. Will the WBO belt stay in Puerto Rico, or will there be a changing of the guard? Five rounds left.
Well, inactivity could be a key in this. He's been an awful lot busier than Zinzurek. This is his 25th fight in 5 years, where it's only the 10th for Santos. And I think that's helping Zinzurek.
He's been averaging one fight a year, Daniel Santos. Not really enough. 30 years of age. Still has the talent and ability. And this is a bit better behind his own jab. Can he come back strongly now? Santos might need to. There's Michael Tim from the Zinzurek corner shouting out instructions, and there's less coming from the Ukrainian.
Well, Santos very talented. He'll know what he has to do. He's overcame problems in the past to pull things round, and he's working hard to do it. Rocks Zinzurek's head backwards.
Good spell for Daniel Santos. Just starting to get that jab working. Needed to wake up call, really, last couple of rounds have been.
Santos can't rely on the single jabs, and he's trying to throw combinations.
From Zinzurek. Not quite been as spot on this round, just looking down to his corner, Zinzurek.
Yes, he just took the foot off the gas in this round. He's allowed Santos back into it. Some good combination punching.
Beating into the jab, really, for the first time in the fight, but a right hook on the chin. Down goes Daniel Santos. Massive breakthrough for Zinzurek. Right at the end of the round. Can he get through it? He's up. He's light on his feet. And Zinzurek with a fantastic shot. And look how the crowd enjoyed that just when Santos was getting back into things. The worst possible thing could have happened to him.
Well, it was the best possible thing for this man, Zinzurek. He found a really good punch there, didn't he? Santos was doing well, was throwing some good combinations. Then Zinzurek found the timing. Just commits himself, Santos, and then just a sharp, good little right hook right on the chin. And he sinks quite heavily down there. Reflexes, very good. Just got him as he was coming in. Doubled the weight up to that punch. Maximum effect.
Seconds out.
No sign that that was coming at all. But what a big advantage for Zinzurek. And especially on the cards. I mean, Santos controlled the whole round, and yet Zinjirut scores the knockdown, so that's 10-8, Glenn.
Yes, 10-8 round, and that's a good one. At this time in the fight, Zinjirut, he needed that one, and that puts him in a nice bit of control here. The crowd getting behind their man.
It's the steady applause from the German fans who appreciate their stand-up boxing, the technical skills shown by many in the past, like Sven Otker, Darius Mikulchevsky. And Sergei Zinjirut has really adapted well, bringing those amateur skills into a pro ring, looking rounded. And well, it's the performance of his career so far. Can he keep it going?
Well, what are we going to see from Daniel Santos now? He must know he's in danger of losing his title unless he can find something pretty big.
Has been down a few times before. Neil Sinclair scored a first round knockdown against Daniel Santos before he was taken out in two. But he has normally got up, Santos, to get on with the job. But the thing is, he may be running out of rounds. We don't know how the judges at ringside, our own Dave Paris, Michael Pernick, and Joachim Jakobsen are seeing things. Don't know, feeling maybe to lean towards Zinjirut through most of it.
Yes, he's come through with some pretty eye-catching punches. He stayed ahead, even when Santos has tried to raise his game, tried to throw shots. Zinjirut's come back, took the center of the ring, regained control.
And mostly behind that stinging, fast, snappy jab. Sergei Zinjirut using that weapon to its full advantage.
He has, for the most part, found Santos pretty easy to catch with that jab. Santos's own defense has not been too good, very upright, hasn't moved ahead.
He's been around nearly a decade. Possibly a slight slowing of reflexes from Santos, a little bit of a lack of head movement, just dabbing his nose there. From Zinjirut, who again finishes the round well. Well, it must be panic stations now in the corner of Daniel Santos. There's some glum looking faces. And, you wonder whether this title is slipping away. Doesn't look happy.
He doesn't. He looks tired. The head's down now of Santos. This is hard. He tried to pick it up in that round, but then Zinjirut let the cleaner, sharper, better shots go. There's a difference in the corners.
It looks fresh, bouncing up. Sergei Zinjirut ready to go. Here's the 10th round, 9 minutes left. World light middleweight title, and now that's the big change. Zinjirut is running away with it.
Yep, he's in a good lead, and everything from the fifth has gone to Zinjirut. Really has taken over in this contest.
Beforehand, Santos ranked about third in the world, and Zinjirut seventh. That may all change, but he's got to get through these crucial last three rounds, where the experience of Santos could just come back into play. He's always known how to win, Daniel Santos.
But he could just have come up against tonight, Glenn, someone a bit quicker, sharper, and on the night better.
Well, he certainly looks very well prepared, Sergei Zenzeruk. You know, he's come here with a game plan. He's trying all the way along to take the fight away from Santos, to get center of the ring, to dominate behind that jab, and that's what he's managed to do.
It's been an odd time for the light middleweights. Roman Karmazin, the Russian, taking out Kasim Uma. Alejandro Garcia coming back into play. Oscar De La Hoya may be returning in the new year. But is this a time to welcome Sergei Zenzeruk into world proceedings? On this evidence, absolutely.
Well, it just looks like he's got the right style to beat Daniel Santos. I think he might struggle with somebody who throws punches in curves and brings them round the side. He's managing to block shots straight to him, but he might find it more difficult if they come round the sides.
Maybe the angles will give him difficulty, but that defense, so hard to prize apart. Santos is not performing badly, Glenn. Just seems to be the edge with Zenzeruk in each of these rounds, or a lot of them.
Santos doesn't seem to be able to find the right way to negate the good jab. Found a shot there, though. That was next to a left hand from Santos. He needs something like that.
Big left hook. Punch of the fight for Daniel Santos. And about time. Well, that could just put a different slant on things.
Okay, weiter so, weiter Operatia. Sergei, alles klar? Operatia. Du musst wieder mit Jeb da sein.
Looking a little more jaded now, Zenzeruk.
Well, just dropped his right hand, didn't he, Zenzeruk?
Okay.
And Santos showing himself a champion there and finding that good left hand. Maybe just starting to tire now Zenzeruk, and this might just be the opening that Santos needs. Zenzeruk did more work in that round. He still won it on points, but it was a good shot at the end from Santos.
Very few of these rounds have been completely clear-cut. It's just a sort of general thinking that Zenzeruk is probably pinching them. He has got that knockdown, remember, in the eighth, which could prove very, very important. Good start to the 11th from Santos. Needs to build on the left hand that shook Zenzeruk in the last session. He needs a big, big finish, Santos, no doubt about that.
He needs a very big finish. He's got to find a big punch. He needs really to get some big rounds by putting Zenzeruk on the floor.
Well, we warned earlier that two southpaws can often make a maul, a bad clash of styles, but Gino Rodriguez, the referees, had absolutely nothing to do. It's been a joy to watch this.
Yes, it really has. Very technical, good skills from both men. They've elected to fight all the time, and you know, one of the rare occasions they come together there.
Boxing skills, tools have been used tonight. Zenzeruk just again rocking that head back of Daniel Santos, who's trying to raise his game.
I think the difference between the two, Adam, has been the sharpness of Zenzeruk. The jab has worked terrifically well, and he's been very, very accurate with his jab.
Do you think that's a combination of the activity he's had, the slightly fresher career,
and maybe the ambition on the night to really grab this.
Yes, I think, you know, looking at the two, he looks a little more jaded, Santos, and yet, you know, he's only had a couple more fights, and, you know, he hasn't really been active very much at all over the last few years.
Beautiful from Sergei Zinjiruk, who's getting through with that jab now with more regularity, really stamping his authority on this fight here in the 11th round. His friend Alexander Dimitrenko, the heavyweight, on his feet at ringside, cheering him on. Is this going to be coronation night for the unheralded Sergei Zinjiruk, who has looked a class act?
Well, I think he's shook Santos with a few of these shots. Santos still trying to fight back.
Crowd raised the tempo again. It's another one for Zinjiruk. Santos frustrated, still trying, still gritting his teeth, but he just can't get through. Well, whatever happens now, Glenn, what a performance from Sergei Zinjiruk in his first world title outing to be doing this to a seasoned world champion.
Well, he's been very motivated. He's had a game plan throughout this. He's done everything right. Hardly made many mistakes. And it's that sort of sharpness that's been the difference. Even when Santos tries to throw his combination, something comes back, and something like that. Excellent left counter from Zinjiruk.
Seconds out. Ring fight.
Marking the eyes up. Got to pull something out of the back. Surely in this, the final round. Little prayer from Daniel Santos. Might know he's got to do something big. I mean, it's been competitive. It's been tight at times. But on your card, Zinjiruk, well winning it.
Yes, he's the boss in there. The better work coming from him, and I think just looking at the two fighters' faces, it's really showing the story of this fight. Looking bruised and swollen now, Daniel Santos.
Mixed success in Germany, Daniel Santos losing to Kotia, then stopping him in the rematch, third appearance here. And is it one that sees his title change hands? We don't know. Three judges may be seeing it differently, but Zinjiruk still holding the position, throwing out the jab, and proving pretty masterful here.
Pretty solid left hand from Santos. Letting Zinjiruk know not to relax yet. This is not over.
He hasn't really had the lazy spells, Daniel Santos, tonight. He's kept his work rate high, but that just doesn't seem to have been good enough.
Well, that's because he's had to fight all the time. Zinjiruk would have took over this fight completely. Santos may well have gotten stopped. He called some good shots, another good left hand, and a good rally from Zinjiruk.
Rattling combination. And the jab again from Zinjiruk. He's putting the finishing touches on what's been the display of his life. And the crowd are feeling this. He must be feeling it. He's on the very verge now.
Well, he's looking very tired, Santos. He's looking for a counter there. I think he'll be happy just to get through this. Been hurt in the final round.
Eyes swelling up, face battered, hardly a mark on Sergei Zinjiruk. Tells the story. 30 seconds to go.
Okay. We saw the eyes of Santos just look up to the clock. He's just happy to get through this.
Zinjerek still getting through with clean shots. It's been a good fight. Excellent to watch these two craftsmen go about it, but the hands go up of Sergei Zinjerek. The crowd are on their feet. There is girlfriend Helena. They believe that Zinjerek is the new world light middleweight champion. He's up on the ring post. And Glenn, doesn't he deserve this?
Well, he certainly does. That was a very good performance. He worked well behind that jab. That was the key. And a big winner on my card. 117-110. Zinjerek's favor. Look at from the fifth round onwards, everything went his way. Really took over the fight.
Crisp, clean, accurate work. And the face of Daniel Santos, the whole body language amongst the camp. I think they feel that they have been beaten. Not official yet, but I think we know, don't we?
Well, look at that. How did he finish this fight? Good combinations in. At one point towards the end, it looked like he may even get the stoppage.
Fritz Studnek looks after the Klitschko's, of course. Big smile on his face. And on Zinjerek's.
Spannenden Kampf erstmal auf die Punktzettel. Now we go to the scorecard. Mike Pernick. 112, 115, 112, 115. Dave Paris, 112, 115, 112, 115. Joachim Jakobsen, 112, 115, 112, 115. We have a unanimous decision. We have einen einstimmigen Punktsieger, meine Damen und Herren. Und es kann nur heißen, neuer WBO-Weltmeister im Superweltergewicht.
He's done it. Sergei Zinjerek is crowned the world light middleweight champion. Fairly close. 115 to 112 on all three cards. A little narrow, Glenn, but they got the right man and the right verdict.
Yep, they certainly did. He deserved it. It was a very good performance.
Sergei Zinjerek, unbeaten in 30, arrives on the world scene. Fabulous performance.